What's up, guys?
Welcome back to the Rabbit Motorworks channel. We're gonna start doing some more work on the 63 Bug, and already done doing a little bit of vacuuming with the getting the old battery out. There's all kinds of debris. We did a really nice job cleaning the car up. So now we're gonna try to get that old gas out, and then from there we're gonna work on trying to crank the car over and see if she'll start. So stay tuned. Okay, ready? Just start it. All right, so we're gonna connect up the battery here. This is our positive, this is our negative. There's this little hat on there for protective, little cap on there. Looks like it's got a 221 date thing, so we'll leave that there. So, probably a better tool than that, but really just gotta get it to contact, so. This snug. I did take a little razor there and cut out the inside of this just to get it so it's nice and clean. So here we go with some power. Okay. Nothing smoking, so that's good. Stop. Sitting a little higher right there. These things are always kind of like this with the, yeah, there's three different things here. Okay, there we go, good enough. All right, so battery's connected. So one of the ways of getting the gas out of the tank is actually you let the fuel pump do the work and pump it out of the tank rather than having to go take off the front wheel. And, you know, basically there's a line that goes from the tank down the body at the front of the car, and that's one way to drain out the tank. So I think what I'm gonna try, because I know there's only about a gallon or so of gas in it, according to the mechanical fuel gauge, I think what I'm gonna do is just basically take and disconnect the fuel line to the carburetor, put it in this small tank, and see if I can actually get it to pump the old gas out of there. Then I've got some new gas, and I'll just basically fill it back in the tank until I get clear coming through. So let's try that and see how it goes.
All right, I'm just gonna video.
So the cool thing is that this fuel line has been replaced probably when you guys had it done. Okay, so that reaches the tank, which is awesome. So that setup right there is good. So I think now we're ready to crank, other than I don't want to start the car. So what I'm going to do is disconnect the coil wire and basically keep that undone so that it's not going to energize the system. So yeah, okay, I think I'll take the, yeah, that's good. Okay, cool. We got lights, so that's cool, which means we got power. This is a 6-volt system, so as you can see, put the lights on, it's pretty dim. So I'm gonna try and see if I can get a turn here and see if it goes. So we got a red and a green light, which is cool. And I think, what's that?
Might have to have your feet on the pedals. I don't know how.
Yes, I don't think on a 63 you're gonna have that kind of safety. Okay, so the other thing is that I think it doesn't have, like, the ignition doesn't seem to be turned over, but there's a button underneath a momentary button underneath the dash here. And I was talking to my wife, and her dad had rigged this up, so I think the ignition switch is basically being bypassed to this other thing. So we'll see if that gives it a try there. So I'm just gonna see if this goes here just by trying to push this button. Here we go. And I got nothing. So let's try that again.
Thank you.
turning really slow. Okay, we lost it again. Okay, so we're making a little bit more progress. I was trying to get the car to turn over. There's a bypass for the starter wire from the ignition switch, and it's basically two solid wires that come down the center tube of the frame, and they connect one to the power, one to the other primary wire for the starter. So there was an eyelet that was on the starter that had broken off, and it started for a minute and then it stopped starting. So it basically, it went underneath there and I found the wire was dancing on top of the eyelet. So I put a new eyelet on that solid copper wire. Now it's turning over, which is cool. So cease. Let's turn it over here. So we are getting it to turn, which is great. So next step is, I think I'm going to take off the air cleaner, and I might even prime it with a little bit of fresh gas, as I got a turkey baster to fill up the carburetor bowl, just to see if I can actually get it to fire. So stay tuned. Does it look like it's spinning? Or
yeah, it's spinning.
It looks like it's really spinning. To me, it should be like going rrr, rrr, rrr. I suppose that's not good that you actually see gas coming out of there.
You don't have to go in that little thing.
Yeah, I'm trying to go in that little thing to fill up the bowl.
Let's get the eyedropper.
This is working. Maybe.
I'm going to get caught on fire.
Okay. Alright. So we got some gas in there. Let's see if we can get any action that way. Ready?
Yeah. Wait. No. Okay. Oh, I felt a little kick there. Oh,
yeah,
heard some.
The green light's off. It was.
My mom has an eyedropper.
It's concerning to me that there's gas dripping out of the linkage. And that tells me that that's not in good shape.
Ooh. Well, that might not help either. Okay, go.
Did you hear that?
Yes, I heard it.
Huh. We're close. More gas. That tells me that there's
fire.
More gas.
Where are we going to put the gas at? In the tank? Where are we going to put the gas at?
I'm sure this carburetor probably needs to be rebuilt. Let's try that.
I think the.
Okay.
Last one. Last try?
Close.
You have to let it settle on there. Mm-hmm. You have to let it settle. You have enough gas in there for a whole tank.
Is there?
I don't know. It's probably just all dripping down in the bottom of the car.
No, I don't think there's anything on the ground. I'm trying to fill this bowl up.
Try it. Let's do it. What do you say, Tom?
I say do it. I say go. Run.
What do you want to say?
Hey, the battery's getting low, so let's try to get battery charger on, see what it says. That's what I think. That's what I think. To me, that thing should really be cranking over fast, but maybe that's not the thing with the Volkswagen. I'm not a Beetle person. I'm learning.
What are you doing right now?
I'm sanding the points down just a bit.
What?
Just to make sure that they, have a good contact, and that there's not a not anything that's preventing them from making a spark. Looks a little gummy. You could probably use a clean, huh? And there is some kind of electric choke on it too. Hmm. What do you think? Think we should put more gas in it?
Yes, let's try it again. Let's do it.
I don't know if I'm putting too much in or not enough, or if it's start up, would it normally just start up right away?
It go rump, 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 rump,
boom.
It would do that a little bit, and then it'd start.
Pretty dark, huh? So, let's just make sure we're getting spark.
Can you watch that while I turn it?
What happens to it?
Let's see a spark.
I don't see it sparking.
Hey guys, so it's the next day as we started running out of daylight, thanks to daylight savings time. However, I think fixed one of the problems, and that was that we weren't getting any spark. So I had a plug out. I was basically trying to test it while we were turning it over. And I took a little bit of emery cloth and filed off the points, and now we got some sparks, so that's great. So now we can probably turn it over and actually see if we can get the thing to turn. So let's try that and see how it goes. Success. She's a runner. Okay, so we primed up the hole in the carburetor, put a new fuel filter on there just to clear out the old one. I put a gallon of new gas in the tank, but there's still probably some remnants of bad stuff. I think that what we're going to end up having to do is definitely drain that other tank. There's a sock in the bottom of that tank. It's like a brass mesh as well too, so. But we're just kind of playing with it just to see if we can get it to start and see if it builds any fuel pressure. So let's give it another turn. Yeah. carburetor bowl. So I would expect more fuel pressure than that coming from that pump. You could see that some of the fuel came up in it, but I don't think it reached up any further than this. So in fact, I'll just take this off here. Yeah. So yeah, there's not definitely not enough fuel being pumped there. I can put a little bit more gas in it, but this is almost empty. I mean, that gas could be bad and clogging up whatever's in that fuel pump. Time nothing pumped in it, just a little bit, huh?
Yeah.
Drain that gas. Basically connected just with a line going from the bottom of the tank all the way down the main part of the car. Well, that's interesting. Nothing's really coming out of the line. So probably mostly because, why don't you go and undo the gas cap and get it some.
I'm taking it off.
Off?
Yes, it's off.
Oh boy, that's a tight fitting nut. That tells you the condition of that line. Okay, so there's a couple of holes in the frame here. They're allowing it to drain at least. So I think that's okay. Boy, is that a dark orange fuel. Okay, here we go. It's interesting, nothing's really coming out of the line. It's just going around it. At least the jack. Yeah, it's just like going directly into the pan, right?
Yeah. Hope this one's on the other side.
Here. Yeah, we'll just go for it. That's like root beer. Not to mention there's a lot of sediment.
Let's see it.
You gotta remember we topped it off with some other gas, so you can only imagine how dark it was before that. was pretty gross. It's even worse, it's the sediment that came out of that. So this is the piece that basically sits underneath like that. You can tell there's some sediment built up around this. It looks like this is clogged as well too, so that's not good. So I just got done taking this hard line off the fuel pump, and I blasted gum out through the hard line because I couldn't get it underneath the front. So what I did is I basically blasted it through this way to the front, and it blasted anything that was in the line out of there, so old fuel got blasted out. So that's good. And then I did throw a little bit of stuff in there to get the old fuel out. So, man, that stuff's just brown looking. It's already got all kinds of sediment that got pushed up. So anyways, we're gonna go through quite a few of these, and that's gonna catch all kinds of sediment. But the cool thing about them is they're clear. So, and the bigger thing is that now they've got all the root beer gas out of there. The bigger thing I'm concerned with is that fuel pump gonna push the fuel forward? So let's look at this thing out in the light here too.
Oh yeah, so that's the supply, and you can see how much restriction is there. So that's definitely gonna get fixed. There's a little washer there. So let's see if we can push that through with some water.
I found just a piece of it. This is tons. Okay.
I can't, you don't have enough wire, I don't think, for this.
That's an interesting diagonal cutters. It's seen some hot wires in its day. That's trash. As a good friend of mine used to say, you're doing some welding with your dykes. Wow, so this is really gummed up. Look at that. So that's gonna, that would be definitely a problem for any kind of you can actually buy replacement ones of these. We're just trying to go for the, let's get it, see if we can get it going. Man, that's really bad. So if this is bad, then that leads me to believe that that filter in the tank is probably bad. This is like, you can see this crud that's coming out of there. It's like a, man. So that would have caused all kinds of drivability problems because that restriction. So make sure we're not pointing this in our face. Yeah. Look at that. So it already can't even get through that. Oh, there it comes. Finally. And that gum out does something to these gloves, I tell you. Okay. Now we should have some flow. The new fuel line on the front, after draining out the tank, the little spigot thing's cleaned. So I took to O'Reilly, and that's all fixed up. So now I primed the carb again. We're gonna give it another start.
see if we can get actual flow coming from new gas from the tank. So let's try that. Enjoyed the video so far. If you haven't already subscribed, please click the subscribe link below to, you know, stay up on this great revival and other cool content, especially in this project. We got the new fuel filter in, and you can see we blew through the brown root beer looking gas, and we're now into some clear gas, so that's awesome.
Start up for a try now.
How's she feel? How's she run?
It feels like it moves. It's moved for the first time in like how many years? 15?
15, 16.
It's cool.
It's never seen daylight.
It's never seen daylight.
The lights work. The door was open.
Was it?
Or unlocked.
It's really kind of
cool. Do you think?
It's really kind of cool. It's the first time I've actually driven a bug before, but look at it on the street. It looks really neat. We got a few things to clean up on it, right? But yeah, it's got all the basics to it. It feels so much different when you get it out of the garage. It's got more of its character to it. So cool. We're going to wrap it up with that, guys. And so thanks for joining the revival here of the 63 Bug. And we'll get on to the next projects of getting it more roadworthy. So stay tuned for the next episode. And thanks for watching.